Ignition sequence starts. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Hey everybody, this is the Digital Asset Investor, and I wanted to give Weiss Ratings, once again, a round of applause. These guys talk about someone who's come a long way. Weiss Ratings is all in on XRP, and they love it because they finally realized this is the greatest digital asset ever created. They tweeted out, this is today, XRP strives to change the way we make cross-border payments. Using XRP, transactions can settle within seconds, and this is huge for private investors and institutions alike. We think the way XRP's consensus works gives it competitive advantage over others in this area. And they're talking about the speed there, but I believe they're also hinting at the defects that have been uncovered in the last month by this proof of work, the mining and the forks and all that business. I think they see the writing on the wall, just like we do now. But moving along, now there's a theme that you're about to see. And that theme is, there's two themes here with this article. But I have too much on, I'm hot. but the theme that you're about to begin to see, and I've kind of touched on this over the last few months. Once Wall Street is ready to come in, you are going to begin to see all of these media outlets, and they're going to be all in on Bitcoin, and Bitcoin will be code for all crypto, but you're going to start to see a tidal wave of articles, because when they're all ready to come in, they're going to be ready, and they're going to be bigger cheerleaders than you and I are. And it'll be for XRP and Bitcoin and all of the core, I would say in the top 5 to 15 of them, the ones that actually have utility. Bitcoin doesn't have any utility, but it was the first mover. It's the only exception in the batch. But you're already starting. I began to see some of these articles as we come towards the end of the year. It's almost like these media outlets have been. It's almost like they've been told and programmed. Okay, we're going to start to flip the script on everything we've been saying going into 2019. I would call 2019 the year of Wall Street, because when you start seeing the media coming out, it's for their benefit, because Wall Street represents the elite and the elite media. Wall Street is the traditional finance. These guys, it has to be their idea for it to be legitimate. And you'll see a little bit of that in the articles I'm talking about here. This one is Wall Street Journal, Bitcoin and Crypto, strongly correlated with gold as stock market struggles. And this was an actual Wall Street Journal article, but I'm not subscribed. It says, this is the Wall Street Journal article. I only get the beginning of it because I'm not a subscriber. Once a rebel, Bitcoin is conforming to mainstream markets. The influx of money from traditional investors has led the cryptocurrency to behave more like a traditional asset. In other words, we can now pat crypto on the head. We're now going to bring you into the fold just in time for Bakkt and Goldman Sachs and all the boys to come into the market, because now it's okay. And the Wall Street Journal, if you think these guys don't make phone calls to Bakkt and Goldman and Morgan and all those companies, and they're not in communication, when they're told to turn on the positive crypto light, it's going to be turned on. And I believe you're already seeing it. This was from today as well. But in this article, what they're saying is they're starting to legitimize this asset class now. This is the beginnings of them legitimizing it. What they're saying here is they're finding a correlation between gold and crypto. Have you heard anybody else say that would happen besides this? This is kind of the theme of what I've been saying all along. When you start to see the real Ponzi scheme collapse, the stock market, and at the same time, simultaneously, you see Wall Street with an opportunity to come into this new asset class, they're telling you right here, new research from Excalibur Pro Inc. shows Bitcoin trading at a 0.84 correlation with gold, as reported by the Wall Street Journal. So they're referring to this article. And so what they're now telling you is that, oh, so now this is all becoming legitimate. Now it's starting to perform the way we think it should. Now it's okay. They're setting the stage. And so I just wanted to show you that. Now, I think the correlation will, I think that we're talking, because this is a new asset class, there won't be any correlation. It will pass gold, and you won't even see gold in the rearview mirror because it's a new asset class. Gold does not have the trillions that are set to come into it the way crypto does. It will far exceed gold in performance over the next few years. Now, I'm not saying, once again, I'm a gold silver fan, okay? But there's one problem with gold and silver, and that is that there's a lot of derivatives. Wall Street has their tentacles all into that, and they can manipulate gold and silver. Crypto has a long ride to go before the real manipulation is in there. But besides that, I would still say I will be a gold and silver guy. I will take a percentage of my gains in crypto over the next few years, and I will put it in gold and silver. Because over the long term, physical, not ETFs, but physical gold and silver will never be a bad investment, because it's real money. It's God's money is what they call it. Moving along, but I wanted to show you another example of, here's another article. Have you seen any of these types of articles in the last 3 months? Bitcoin is making a comeback in 2019 as the cryptocurrency market matures, at Kearney predicts. And I want to read to you, this is their prediction. According to management consultancy at Kearney, there could be a plot twist coming up in the Bitcoin story in 2019. In its latest year ahead predictions 2019 report, the firm predicted that cryptocurrencies will begin a second decade in a state of post-crash consolidation and maturation. By the end of 2019, Bitcoin will reclaim nearly two-thirds of the crypto market capitalization as altcoins lose their luster because of growing risk aversion among cryptocurrency investors, the report said. At Kearney expects financial regulations surrounding cryptocurrencies to soften as authorities target criminal activity that causes price volatility. It also expects the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission will warm to Bitcoin exchange-traded funds. Ironically for cryptocurrencies, to see a third decade, the only viable path forward involves this acceptance by the international financial system that Bitcoin once sought to defeat, it added. Now, there's a couple of things in there. The first is all of these Bitcoin maximalists all these years have talked about how, you know, they're anarchists and we don't need the banking system. And where do they find themselves now? They are the hero of the banking system. They are the banking system. Bitcoin is being lauded more by the traditional financial system than any digital asset. And on top of that, we find out that they're not decentralized. Because all this proof of work mining business, Roger Ver and Craig Wright, they've exposed it for not being decentralized, because they've admitted they can control proof of work by having more mining power, the hash power, whatever. But I wanted to make another point in this. These guys, they said that they believe that Bitcoin will take nearly two-thirds of the crypto market capitalization and the altcoins will lose their luster. I agree with part of this. Bitcoin will reclaim a lot of market cap, but many altcoins that are worthless, which is probably almost 1,000 of them, yes, they will disappear and go to zero. But the ones that are better tech than Bitcoin, that actually have utility, XRP, ding, 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 and a handful of others will challenge Bitcoin. And I believe XRP will overtake Bitcoin. So that part of this, I think they're wrong on. But anyway, moving along, I just thought that was important. It's important to show you that all of a sudden, out of nowhere, now they want to start writing positive articles about crypto. And this becomes a domino effect, all of these positive articles. Next, I wanted to, what I forgot, I did not leave up here, and it's the final article I wanted to show you that shows, that illustrates that the tide is turning in the media, the whole media line is changing, and it's right as we go up to 2019, almost like it was a plan. Time Magazine today had an article, and the article was Why Bitcoin Matters for Freedom. And it was a pro-Bitcoin. The whole thing was talking about how the poor people of the world are controlled by authoritarian regimes, and that Bitcoin would allow them to not be controlled economically. And I didn't keep the article up. And the reason I didn't is because Time Magazine, being the dinosaur media that it is, Time Magazine has ads all over the thing, and it was just slowing my computer down to a crawl. So I closed it, and I kept the last paragraph out of it because I wanted you to hear this. It says, when you think about this, I want you to think, well, shoot, if Bitcoin's 1%, what is XRP? It says, less than 1% of the world's population, no more than 40 million people, have ever used Bitcoin. So imagine what it is for XRP. And then it says, but according to the Human Rights Foundation, more than 50% of the world's population lives under authoritarian regime. If we invest the time and resources to develop user-friendly wallets, more exchanges, and better educational materials for Bitcoin, it has the potential to make a real difference for the 4 billion people who can't trust their rulers or who can't access the banking system. For them, Bitcoin can be a way out. So see, what I've been telling you for the last, since May, is that not only are these people, when the time comes and it feels like they are beginning, it feels like the media is beginning to turn and say, okay, now it's time to take all of our guns and point them in the other direction, and we want to shoot this crypto thing off. And that's what I've always thought they would do, is when the time came and when they're told to do so, they're going to send it all through the roof, but everybody had to be parked before doing it. That's been my theory all along. Finally, now what I'm about to show you is a little scary, but not if you're doing the right things. This is a tweet from Mr. B. He's talking, this is about Coinbase. This is a guy with a YouTube channel, and he said, Mr. B says, and follow Mr. B if you don't, at XRP Mister. He's major active in the XRP community. I think I featured him earlier today. Check this video out. Alert, Coinbase just delayed my 10 Litecoin withdrawal for 3 days. Now, I watched part of this video, and here's the gist of what this guy said, and I'm going to give you my take on it, then I'm going to show you what this is really about. He said he bought $200 worth of Litecoin, and then they sent him a, I think he said they sent him an email saying that they were worried about fraud or something, and so they weren't going to release. He wanted to send the Litecoin out from Coinbase, and that they were going to hold it for 72 hours. Well, I don't know exactly the situation here, because I don't know if he put the $200 on there and he just put it on there and then expected to get it off right then. But my experience, because I still use Coinbase occasionally, Coinbase used to, if you bought Bitcoin, for instance, used to, your Bitcoin would not show up at Coinbase. They would take your, say, $200, and the Bitcoin would not be there for 5 or 6 days. And then you could do what you wanted with it. Now, if I bought $200 of Bitcoin, the Bitcoin will be instantly available on their platform, but it won't be available for me to transfer out for like 5 days, okay? And so I don't know what his situation specifically is here, but the way he described it is kind of the same thing I go through all the time with them anyway. But here's the reason that videos like this are being made, and the reason that people are getting a little freaked out. It's because of this thing called proof of keys is coming, but what is it? this is an article from 10 days ago, okay? And proof of keys is up, I think it's kind of being headed up by a guy on Twitter, Trace Mayer. And it says he's promoting a crypto ownership awareness called Proof of Keys. In the event, cryptocurrency holders are urged to remove their crypto assets from exchanges and other third parties in an effort to prove solvency. Okay? And the quote here is, by demanding and taking possession of their assets, individuals will learn fast with blockchain proof whether they are part of the elite hodlers or not. Proof of Keys is the annual hodler initiation. In other words, here's what they're trying to do, people. What they're saying is all these crypto exchanges that claim you go on, let's say you go on to Coinbase and you buy 10 Bitcoin. What they're saying is Coinbase and all of these exchanges, they claim that they have your digital assets on those exchanges and that they are protecting your digital assets. And what this is what Reagan used to call trust but verify. They're trying to verify that these guys are actually that they actually have these things on their exchanges. And so, you know, I've been talking to you a lot about Ledger wallets. Don't leave any of this stuff to chance. I mean, Ledger still has a sale, I guess through maybe the first or whatever. I don't know. But you can go to the description of every single one of my videos and go get a Ledger Nano S. Take it off of these exchanges. Let me give you a scenario. I've seen it happen. Let's say that these guys and this proof of keys thing, this is going to happen on January the 3rd. Okay. Let's say that Coinbase or any of them. Let's say that your exchange you held on Coinbase 10 Bitcoin and this proof of keys thing happened and Coinbase, it came out. Coinbase is a bad example because they're probably more well to do than many exchanges, but let's say you were with an average exchange and it was found out that actually they weren't holding when this thing was done, this proof of keys event happened. It was found out that they were not doing what they said. Well, an exchange can go out of business right quick in a scenario like that. And what they do, I've shown you this before, what they do, the first thing they do when they get in financial trouble, if there's a run on an exchange like that and they actually aren't holding those digital assets, guess what happens? They tell you that they can't send out your Bitcoin. Okay? And so do not leave your things on an exchange. Like I said, in the description of every video I do, there's a link to Ledger and you can get these. It's a hard wallet. It's the safest way to hold your digital assets. You hold them off the exchanges in a hard wallet. It's the safest way to do it. I'm the digital asset investor. I'm not an investment advisor. This is for entertainment purposes only. Please subscribe, hit the like button, and tell your friends and family to get a Ledger Nano S. Do not leave their digital assets on an exchange. Thank you for listening and have a good weekend.